Hey, Shalom Akim, Yahweh Shemel Shah Barakatum. Today we're going to read the book of Judith, chapters 7 and 8. This is the book of Judith, chapter 7. The next day, Holofernes commanded all his army and all his people, which were come to take his part, that they should remove their camp against Bethulia, to take aforehand the ascents of the hill country, and to make war against the children of Israel. Then their strong men removed their camps in that day, and the army of the men of war was 170,000 footmen and 12,000 horsemen, beside the baggage and the other men that were afoot among them, a very great multitude. And they camped in the valley near unto Bethulia by the fountain, and they spread themselves in breadth over against Othaim, even to Belmaim, and in length from Bethulia unto Siamon, which is over against Ezraelim. Now the children of Israel, when they saw the multitude of them, were greatly troubled, and said every one to his neighbor, "Now will these men lick up the face of the earth, for neither the high mountains, nor the valleys, nor the hills are able to bear their weight." Then every man took up his weapons of war, and when they had kindled fires upon their towers, they remained and watched all that night. But in the second day, Holofernes brought forth all his horsemen in the sight of the children of Israel, which were in Bethulia, and viewed the passages up to the city, and came to the fountains of their waters, and took them, and set garrisons of men of war over them, and he himself removed toward his people. Then came unto him all the chief of the children of Esau, and all the governors of the people of Moab, and the captains of the sea coast, and said, "Let our Lord now hear a word, that there be not an overthrow in thine army. For this people of the children of Israel do not trust in their spears, but in the height of the mountains wherein they dwell, because it is not easy to come up to the tops of their mountains. Now therefore, my Lord, fight not against them in battle array, and there shall not so much as one man of thy people perish. Remain in thy camp, and keep all the men of thine army, and let thy servants get into their hands the fountain of water, which issueth forth of the foot of the mountain. For all the inhabitants of Bethulia have their water thence, so shall thirst kill them, and they shall give up their city, and we and our people shall go up to the tops of the mountains that are near, and we will camp upon them, to watch that none go out of the city. So they and their wives and their children shall be consumed with famine, and before the sword come against them, they shall be overthrown in the streets where they dwell. Thus shalt thou render them an evil reward, because they rebelled and met not thy person peaceably." And these words pleased Holofernes and all his servants, and he appointed to do as they had spoken. So the camp of the children of Ammon departed, and with them 5,000 of the Assyrians, and they pitched in the valley and took the waters, and the fountains of the waters of the children of Israel. Then the children of Esau went up with the children of Ammon, and camped in the hill country over against Othaim. And they sent some of them toward the south, and toward the east, over against Agrebel, which is near unto Cusai, that is upon the brook Machmor. And the rest of the army of the Assyrians camped in the plain, and covered the face of the whole land. And their tents and carriages were pitched to a very great multitude. Then the children of Israel cried unto the Lord their power, because their heart failed, for all their enemies had compassed them round about, and there was no way to escape out from among them. Thus all the company of Ashur remained about them, both their footmen, chariots, and horsemen, 40 days, so that all their vessels of water failed, all the inhabitants of Bethulia. And the cisterns were emptied, and they had not water to drink their fill for one day, for they gave them drink by measure. Therefore, their young children were out of heart, and their women and young men fainted for thirst, and fell down in the streets of the city, and by the passages of the gates, and there was no longer any strength in them. Then all the people assembled to Ozias, and to the chief of the city, both young men and women and children, and cried with a loud voice, and said before all the elders, "Yahweh be judge between us and you, for ye have done us great injury, and that ye have not required peace of the children of Ashur. For now we have no helper, But Yahweh have sold us into their hands, that we should be thrown down before them with thirst and great destruction. Now therefore call them unto you, and deliver the whole city for a spoil to the people of Holofernes, and to all his army. For it is better for us to be made a spoil unto them, than to die for thirst. For we will be his servants, that our souls may live, and not see the death of our infants before our eyes, nor our wives, nor our children to die. We take to witness against you the heaven and the earth, and our power and Lord of our fathers, which punisheth us according to our sins and the sins of our fathers, that he do not according as we have said this day. Then there was great weeping with one consent in the midst of the assembly, and they cried unto the Lord power with a loud voice. Then said Ozias to them, Brethren, be of good courage. Let us yet endure 5 days, in the which space the Lord our power may turn his mercy toward us, for he will not forsake us utterly. And if these days pass, and there come no help unto us, I will do according to your word. And he dispersed the people, every one to their own charge. And they went unto the walls and towers of their city, and sent the women and children into their houses, and they were very low brought in the city. This is the book of Judith, chapter 8. Now at that time, Judith heard thereof, which was the daughter of Merari, the son of Ox, the son of Joseph, the son of Aziel, the son of Elsiah, the son of Ananias, the son of Gideon, the son of Raphaim, the son of Asitho, the son of Eliu, the son of Eliab, the son of Nathanael, the son of Samael, the son of Salasadai, the son of Israel. And Manasseh was her husband of her tribe and kindred, who died in the barley harvest. For as he stood overseeing them that bound sheaves in the field, the heat came upon his head, and he fell on his bed, and died in the city of Bethulia. And they buried him with his fathers in the field between Dothan and Baalamo. So Judith was a widow in her house 3 years and 4 months. And she made her a tent upon the top of her house, and put on sackcloth upon her loins, and wear her widow's apparel. And she fasted all the days of her widowhood, save the eves of the Sabbaths, and the Sabbaths, and the eves of the new moons, and the new moons, and the feast and solemn days of the house of Israel. She was also of a goodly countenance, and very beautiful to behold. And her husband Manasseh had left her gold and silver and men servants and maid servants and cattle and lands, and she remained upon them. And there was none that gave her an ill word, for she feared Yahweh greatly. Now when she heard the evil words of the people against the governor, that they fainted for lack of water, for Judith had heard all the words that Ozias had spoken unto them, and that he had sworn to deliver the city unto the Assyrians after 5 days, then she sent her waiting woman that had the government of all things that she had to call Ozias and Cabris and Carmis, the ancients of the city. And they came unto her, and she said unto them, Hear me now, O ye governors of the inhabitants of Bethulia, for your words that ye have spoken before the people this day are not right, touching this oath which ye made and pronounced between Yahweh and you, and have promised to deliver the city to our enemies, unless within these days the Lord turn to help you. And now who are ye that have tempted Yahweh this day, and stand instead of Yahweh among the children of men? And now try the Lord Almighty, but ye shall never know anything. For ye cannot find the depth of the heart of man, neither can ye perceive the things that he thinketh. Then how can ye search out Yahweh, that hath made all things, and know his mind, or comprehend his purpose? Nay, my brethren, provoke not the Lord our power to anger. For if he will not help us within these 5 days, he hath power to defend us when he will, even every day, or to destroy us before our enemies. Do not bind the counsels of the Lord our power, for Yahweh is not as man, that he may be threatened, neither is he as the son of man, that he should be wavering. Therefore, let us wait for salvation of him, and call upon him to help us, and he will hear our voice if it please him. For there arose none in our age, neither is there any now in these days, neither tribe, nor family, nor people, nor city among us, which worship gods made with hands, as have been aforetime. For the which cause our fathers were given to the sword, and for a spoil, and had a great fall before our enemies. But we know none other God. Therefore we trust that he will not despise us, nor any of our nation. For if we be taken so, all Judea shall lie waste, and our sanctuary shall be spoiled, and he will require the profanation thereof at our mouth. In the slaughter of our brethren, in the captivity of the country, in the desolation of our inheritance, will he turn upon our heads among the Gentiles, wheresoever we shall be in bondage. And we shall be an offense and a reproach to all them that possess us. For our servitude shall not be directed to favor, but the Lord our power shall turn it to dishonor. Now therefore, O brethren, let us shew an example to our brethren, because their hearts depend upon us, and the sanctuary and the house and the altar rest upon us. Moreover, let us give thanks to the Lord our power, which tried us, even as he did our fathers. Remember what things he did to Abraham, and how he tried Isaac, and what happened to Jacob in Mesopotamia of Syria, when he kept the sheep of Laban his mother's brother. For he hath not tried us in the fire, as he did them, for the examination of their hearts. Neither have he taken vengeance on us, but the Lord doth scourge them that come near unto him to admonish them. Then said Ozias to her, all that thou hast spoken hast thou spoken with a good heart, and there is none that may gainsay thy words. For this is not the first day wherein thy wisdom is manifested, but from the beginning of thy days all the people have known thine understanding, because the disposition of thine heart is good. But the people were very thirsty, and compelled us to do unto them as we have spoken, and to bring an oath upon ourselves, which we will not break. Therefore now pray thou for us, because thou art a godly woman, and the Lord will send us rain to fill our cisterns, and we shall faint no more. Then said Judith unto them, hear me, and I will do a thing, which shall go throughout all generations to the children of our nation. Ye shall stand this night in the gate, and I will go forth with my waiting woman, and within the days that ye have promised to deliver the city to our enemies, the Lord will visit Israel by mine hand. But inquire not ye of mine act, for I will not declare it unto you till the things be finished that I do. Then said Ozias and the princes unto her, go in peace, and the Lord power be before thee to take vengeance on our enemies. So they returned from the tent and went to their wards. That's the book of Judith, chapters 7 and 8. Yahba Shemuel Shai Barakatum, and as always, double shalom.